This is Channels Television. We interrupt our regular programs to cross over to Port Harcourt for our live coverage of the commissioning of Tombia Road Extension by the River State Government. Stay with us.
Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, please can we put our hands together for all our own community women. Thank you very much. Thank you so much. Thank you. Please let's put our hands together for them as they dance out. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. As the dance out, may I now invite the Rumokpakani community women.
Do. I'm not going to do it.
and gentlemen, please can we put our hands together for them? Thank you very much. May I now invite the Oboni Cultural Group.
Come back now.
Your Excellencies, the Distinguished Ladies and Gentlemen, please can we put our hands together for them as we dance up? Thank you very much. Thank you so much. May I now invite to Three Lords, the Owembe Cultural Dance Group.
Thank you.
gentlemen, please can we put our hands together for Wembe Cultural Dance Group. Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, for the project description, may I invite the Honorable Commissioner for Works, Elokata Siamadi, Esquire.
Your Excellency, the Governor of River State, our special guest of honor, His Excellency, Right Honorable Ifeanyi Ugwuanyi, Governor of Enugu State, Our Excellency, the Deputy Governor of River State, the Honorable Speaker of the River State House of Assembly, Your Excellency, the former Governor of River State, Your Excellencies, please permit me to adopt protocols previously established. Your Excellency, our co-City Governor, you are welcome to the Treasurer Base of the Nation. Having concluded yesterday's commissioning ceremony of Dualai's Zimbu Road, I am proud to announce to you that thanks to His Excellency, my Governor, I have successfully attained the enviable milestone of having described 38 landmark projects, including 5 flyovers, in 13 months. Today's description will make it 39, and that averages 3 projects every month. When your Governor gives you bragging rights, you enjoy it, so please pardon me anytime I get too exuberant. Thank you. Since this round of commissioning began a few days ago, I have had the pleasure and privilege of taking you through a brief of flyovers number 4 and 5, situated at Rumola and GRA Junction respectively. Yesterday was Dualai's Ezimbu Road, and today I will be telling you a little about the Dualai's Tumbia Extension Road. Prior to reconstruction and dualization, we had a single carriageway that was merely 6.5 meters wide, with open drains, no sidewalks, and no streetlights. Today we have a dual carriageway, 7.3 meters wide, headed in either direction, separated by a 0.7 meter wide median, bounded by covered drains and walkways on either side, making a total project width of 18.35 meters, beautifully adorned with streetlights. As is our standard, the road pavement starts with a sub-base of sharp sand, stabilized with a 5% sand-cement mix, topped with stone-based course, primed with bituminous coating to receive the first asphaltic concrete layer, after which we top it off with a second asphalt-wearing course, leaving you with a total asphalt thickness of 10 centimeters, or 4 inches if you may. We encountered quite a few challenges during construction, primarily because this area is basically swamp, and most, if not all, the building developments are on reclaimed land. Reclaimed with some of the most unstable layers of material one could use for that purpose. During excavation for drains, cave-ins were common. This was exacerbated by the fact that we're working in a fully built-up area. Relocation of electric facilities became a slow, arduous task. We even had to use the drains to retain the soil and hold the poles in place. In a nutshell, it was painstaking and cumbersome. Some sections of this road had to be covered with geotextiles deep under the subbase to keep back groundwater. Otherwise, we would have fountains of underground water springing from the road surface. These are some of the things we encounter in our road projects here in River State, which are always invisible to the eye. Women who are good cooks can relate to what I'm talking about. When a dish of sweet soup appears on the dining table, we have no idea what went into the preparation. So, Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, the difference between what then was and what now is makes a world of difference in terms of speed, travel time, convenience, aesthetics, property value appreciation, and much more. These and some more things are goals of His Excellency's Urban Renewal Program, a program designed ultimately to leave the state in better infrastructural shape with each passing day. This dualization offers to commuters a world of ease and to property owners great improvement in their property location and value. Your Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I can go on and on, but let me save some for another day. But one thing I want you to take home is that this road was built with the best intentions and desires. Like all our other projects, it has been built not just to say we have built roads, but built for you to drive by many years later and see that you have roads. If these roads must last, we also all must take responsibility and ownership, protecting them from those who have chosen to be public enemies. We, as a matter of duty, must prevent and avoid burning tires on the road, spilling oil, diesel, petroleum products, because these destroy the wearing course and allow water to penetrate, ultimately leading to collapse of our roads. Your Excellency, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, thank you for gracing the occasion. God bless you all.
Thank you very much. Please note that the projects that were mentioned were those done only under the Ministry of Works. Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, may I now invite to give a remark on behalf of the contractor, Julius Berger Nigeria Limited, PLC, Jürgen Fischer, the regional manager.
Welcome to His Excellency Nyesom Esenwo Wike, to Executive Governor of River State, the special guest of honor, His Excellency Ifeani Ugwuani, Governor of Enugu State, Her Excellency Miss Ipaalibo Hari Banigo, the Deputy Governor of River State, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. Please permit me to stay on the existing protocol. Julius Berger PLC welcomes all of you today to this commissioning ceremony. Today we are here to celebrate the commissioning of the Tombia Road extension. This road is the final component of the road development at the GRE junction area and is the gap closure of the east-west connection from Stadium Road to Iqueri Road. I can only repeat that we are very grateful to have again been given the opportunity to contribute to His Excellency's Urban Renewal Program. Therefore, I want to say thank you to Your Excellency, also in behalf of the entire executive management, for once again trusting Julius Berger PLC for the realization of this project. Construction is a teamwork and cannot be done alone. Also here was a professional team behind the execution, and I want to thank and highlight them. First of all, the Ministry of Works, under the leadership of Honorable Commissioner Eloka Tazi Amadi, and his entire team. And also my own project team under the leadership of Engineer Tana Özakan and his entire team. And last but not least, a special thank to the good people of River State, especially the host community here, for their support patience and understanding during the construction time. Thank you very much, and God bless this project, and God bless you all. Thank you.
Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, at this point, may I respectfully invite to give his speech, the Governor of Rivers State, His Excellency Yesu Ezewa Wike, Commander of the Order of the Niger, Grand Seven Star of Rivers State, Power of Sports, Africa.
Your Excellency, our special guest of honor, the Governor of Enugu State, Buruburu Ndi Igbo, my brother, Ifeanyi Ugwuanyi, Your Excellency, the Deputy Governor, Your Excellency, the former Governor of the State, the distinguished senators here, and members of the House of Representatives, Chairman of our party, former Deputy Speakers of the House of Representatives, Chairman of Elders Forum, members of the State Executive Council, former ministers that are here, particularly the former Minister of Justice and Attorney General, Madam Bello Adoke, other leaders that are here, gentlemen of the press, the Chairman of the Rivers Traditional Law Council and members of your council, gentlemen of the press, ladies and gentlemen. Your Excellency, our special guest of honor, let me, on behalf of the government and people of the state, most sincerely appreciate and thank you for honoring our invitation in spite of a short notice. This is the second time His Excellency has honored us to come and identify with us and commission our projects. I do know that you commissioned one of our projects sometimes this year. That shows the brotherhood, that shows the love you have for the people of the state. Like I said yesterday, sometimes it is good for people to have, and that's one thing I've always told the Minister of Works, to keep a complete video to show the position of the roads before the reconstruction or construction, so that people can have a 5 minute glance of what was and what is there. Picture on the papers may not really tell the correct story. But I'm sure Pastor Zilia Agri, who is here today, is highly overwhelming with joy because he has the Royal House of Grace Church here. When he invited me to come to the church, it was a problem. In fact, the membership of his church reduced to the point that he was saying what was he going to do. People don't go to the church because of how bad this road was. So when I told him that we're going to reconstruct this road and to Julius Berger, he was just looking at me whether can this be a reality. So when we started for demolition and compensation, he was the first person that called me that, look, I'm not going to wait for any demolition. I'm going to do my own first and do the fencing. That shows how important this road is to him. I'm sure the community, the Rumeme community, must be happy. You know one thing about community, when you want to touch their buildings, they are not always happy. No matter the compensation you may pay. Most of them have one or two lock-up shops where they collect money monthly or yearly, as the case may be. And there's no amount of compensation the government can give that can be enough or adequate to even build new lock-up stores. But again, they appreciated and realized that, look, this is for the interest of us, this is for the development of our area. I'm sure the rural community, they are happy that today this road has been dualized and fitted with electricity. The only way you can enjoy this road is to come in the night, not in the daytime. If you come in the night, you'll appreciate what God has done to our communities. And I thank them for the support they gave to Julius Berger and Adair Limited, because some communities will always disturb any work going. At the end of the day, the contractors will leave the site, and government will suffer, the community will suffer. But this is a different case where I was meant to understand our intelligence, they never bothered to worry the company. I'm sure also the company must have also done their own homework by allowing the local content to be involved. So this is what we expect from communities. This is the kind of support we want from you. And as I said, one of the communities that has always supported PDP is the Rumemi community. It's a community that when they say they are with you, they are with you. It's a community you can go home and sleep. It's a community that can go home and sleep. And to God be the glory, they have seen the fruit of supporting PDP. The law school is the Rumemi community. I mean, what support? What support will you need? How facilities can bring out the name of a community? If the Nigerian Law School opens tomorrow, and everybody says, look, the new campus of the Nigerian Law School in Rumemi. So Rumemi will be a household name in the entire Nigeria. It's not only money that you get that you think you have gotten dividend, but the name alone that social institution, social establishment is in your community. Money cannot buy it. So I thank you. And like I said, this is one of the promises we have made and fulfilled. And I have challenged our people that government is not only by making promises. Government should make promise and fulfill the promise. And that is why I have said, we too, who are the public, we too, who are the citizens, should be able to hold us accountable for whatever we say, should hold us accountable for whatever promise we make. Not tomorrow, you forget, somebody will come and tell you, you know, we can tell you, we made mistakes, but now we are ready to correct the mistake. Tell them not nothing to correct again. There's nothing to correct. The party we know that has told us yesterday night that they are going to do this, they have done it. So we want to continue to remain with that party that made promises to us and that fulfilled those promises. So that is what it's supposed to be. And I thank all of you for coming out in mass to give all the support. As I said yesterday, this road is Zimbu Street, and Jerry flyover was awarded one day. And so the Jezdora started the three projects the same day. Construction of the flyover, construction of the Zimbu Road, and construction of Tombia extension. It is important that people should know and completed it on record time. I want to thank Julius Berger PLC for taking our job very seriously. You may say we are then not paid. We are aware of so many companies that are also paid, yet one reason or the other, tomorrow, today, variation upon variation. Oh, it has been raining. The day where they collected the money during the rainy season. So, but Julius Berger, that is not the case. He has the capacity, he has the machinery, whether it is ready or not, they will always work. Let me finally say to people, traditional rulers, the man who represented the Yenwen or Rumemi, let me say clearly, people must understand that government is not a family meeting. Government is not a community meeting. Government must be serious. Nobody should take my administration for granted because you know me. Nobody should do that next time. If you have any problem, you should know how to channel your problem. Tombi Extension was not named by me. Tombi Extension has been there. You have never one day written to government that please change this name. It shouldn't be Tombi Extension. The mere fact will give you the opportunity to come and present Kunanot is not the reason why you take that before me to come and grave issues that will cause problems. Next time anybody tries it, I will teach you as the governor of the state, and heaven will not fall. So people should know you have people who are in government, you have people who are in the party. I let the chairman of the party in our LGA is for Rumeme, and he can reach me anytime, any day. You have your son Timothy Sirim, he can reach me any day, anytime. So I don't understand why you don't know how to channel your problems, not in the public here. Please. So I thank all of you for coming and continue to support the government. Tomorrow we have another commissioning at the state government safe home. Day after tomorrow, we'll go to Ahuda to commission the Ojoku internal roads. So for us, it is commissioning and flag off and flag off until we leave May 29, 2023. On that note, let me invite my dear friend, special guest of honor, Bulbul Ndibo, to come and talk to the people of the state, and thereafter, commission. Thank you and God bless you.
What else?
Your Excellency, the Governor of Rivers State, Yelson Ezenwike, Your Excellency, the Deputy Governor, Your Excellency, the former governors, may I please stand on well-established protocol. On behalf of the government and good people of Enugu State, I extend my warm felicitations to you on this remarkable occasion. It is my profound honor to be with you today on the special invitation of my brother Governor, His Excellency Yosom Wike, CON, GSSRS, POS Africa, to commission the elegantly completed Tombia Extension Road GRA Port Harcourt River State, 1.7-kilometer double-layer asphalt paved dual carriageway, 7.3-kilometer on east side with 0.75-meter wide median, concrete line drains, culvert sidewalk, and interpolating beautiful street lights. This strategic and high utility road is at the heart of Port Harcourt Metropolis and will significantly ease traffic, reduce commute time, and make life more meaningful for all users of the road. I recall that on the 5th day of January 2021, I had occasion to be with you on a similar invitation to commission the then newly dualized Sabuemo-Obori Road that serves the Ogoni heartland. It was a fulfilling experience, and I returned to the Coast City State with good tidings of exciting progress and great hope for infrastructural development in River State, the treasure base of the nation. Today's experience evidences a quantum leap in the infrastructural development of this great state, and I dare say that my brother, the Governor of River State, is truly Mr. Project. Your Excellency, I speak from the depth of my conviction, and I'm very proud of your accomplishments in this regard. You are a veritable source of pride to our great party PDP, and you represent the best of the best in project implementation. You inspire great trust and confidence in our constitutional democracy, and I pray the Almighty God to bless the works of your hands. I thank the good people of River State, whose invaluable prayers, support, and solidarity provide the impetus for this outstanding project delivery. I encourage you to remain steadfast and offer you my best wishes of a Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year in advance. Finally, it is my great privilege to formally commission the newly dualized Tombia Extension Road GRA Port Harcourt River State to the glory of God and benefit of humanity. Thank you and God bless.
Papa said. 2, 3, 4.
We thank the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob, the also God of David. May all glory and honor be yours forever. The realization of Tobia Road Extension, executed by the administration of His Excellency, Your Excellency Mwen Wike, CONGSSRS, Governor of Rivers State, commissioned by His Excellency Ifeanyi Ugwuanyi, Governor of Enugu State, on this 14th day of December 2021. To God be the glory.
The national anthem.
This is Channels Television. You've been watching our live coverage of the commissioning of Tombia Road Extension in Port Harcourt by the Rivers State Government. The honors were done by the Enugu State Governor, His Excellency Ifeanyi Ugwuanyi. But from Rivers State, we're going to cross over immediately to Igbo State for the National Micro, Small and Medium Enterprise Clinic, where the Vice President of Nigeria, Professor Yemi Osinbajo, is a special guest. Right there in Owerri, Imo State capital.